Hey guys, Raider here. Hope you're all doing great and having a fantastic day. Today we're going to be unboxing and taking a look at the Quntis Smart PD 65 watt charging station that features three USB-A type ports, one of them 3 amps, two of them 2 amps, and it also features two USB-C ports, and one of these are super fast charging at 65 watts. And the other one goes down to like 30, 35. So before we get started, guys, full disclosure, I did get this product sent to me free from the manufacturer, and the deal was real simple. They'll send out the product. If I like it after using it for a while, I'll go ahead and put a review on my channel and give you guys a link with the discount code and all that stuff. And if I don't like it, I just don't do the review, scrap it, throw it in the garbage, do whatever. And they totally agreed with it. They were fine with it. And with the 10% coupon code that you can find down in the description, that takes us down to about 32 bucks. All right, guys, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna do the unboxing. I'm gonna go ahead and show you the ports and stuff real quick. We're gonna go over the pros and cons, and we'll do some charging comparisons with the app called Ampere. And we'll see how this compares to Samsung's more expensive single port USB chargers. This is the one that comes with the Galaxy Book 2 Pro 360. We're also going to address a couple user complaints. We'll wrap up with pros and cons, and then I'll let you guys know if I think it's worth your money. All right, guys, without further ado, let's go ahead and start the unboxing. Now, just so you know, I have been using this for a little bit, guys, but I did pack this back up in the box, just like you'll get it when you receive it. Pretty nice packaging. Let me walk you around it real quick. Just talks about it a little bit. Even has some contact information on the side. It's pretty nice when a company backs themselves up by showing their contact info. And you get all the specs on the bottom too for quick reference. This does have circuitry protection like you would expect on most modern chargers, so it won't catch your house on fire or blow up your devices. Those things are always a plus. So here we go. When we open up the box, we've got the device itself up top. Comes with a little wrap around it. Takes a plug in the back, which I absolutely love. We're going to talk about that more in the pros and when we set this up. And then we have our four ports, the top one being basically the big daddy port. This one charges at 65 watts. It is equivalent to this port here on the Samsung charger. And the remaining ports have different wattages based upon how many different devices you're charging at once. So we'll set this to the side. You get some documentation. And it has the port speeds and all the stuff that you expect as well. You have the cable to plug into the back, and it even comes with a little holding cradle to put it in. So I haven't used this yet. I assume it just goes, yeah, like so. How about that? That's pretty cool. I like that a lot, so you can set it up on your desk. All right, guys, we've got it unboxed. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to grab a bunch of devices. We're going to load up the Ampere amp so we can test this out, and let's see how well it compares to our Samsung brick here. All right, guys, for the first test, we're going to go ahead and start with one device. So I've got the Tab S8 Ultra. Right now, it's currently plugged in to the Samsung brick that comes with the Galaxy Book 2 Pro 360. We're at about 49% charge on the device right now, so it's not going to do super fast charging, but it should do regular charging until we get close to 80%. And you can see here, we are charging, our current charging speed via the Ampere app is 4,730 milliamps. That's the current flow going to the tablet. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and unplug the Samsung power brick. And you'll see here we have this cord coming from the device. We're gonna start with the top port. That's a 65 watt port, same as the Samsung one. Let's see what we get here. Give it a moment to measure. All right, let it kick up. And we are getting a slightly faster, yet still within the safe range, charging speed out of the Quntis 65 watt. Let's go ahead and bring it down to the lower port. This is supposed to be about half the amperage. Let's see what we get when we don't need a fast charge. So you can see with the tablet being this much charged already, it's still able to push out the whole 5,360 milliamps just like it was on the top port. So far this thing's working out great. So you can see I got a couple Galaxy Book 2 Pros there. Let me go grab an iPad, an iPhone. Let's get a few devices in here. Then we're gonna do a full multi-device test here. Let's see what the amperage draw reduces down to. I have a feeling it's going to drop down significantly once we connect a whole bunch of devices together. It should, because it's 65 watts max. All right, guys, I'll be right back. All right, guys, we're back. So let me throw a couple user complaints up on the screen here. And there's not many of them. This has like 4.5 out of 5 stars on Amazon. But you'll see here the first one talks about hooking multiple devices up and they'll not charge all at the same time. And the second complaint, when hooking up an iPad and an iPhone at the same time, they're not both charging at the same time when using other devices as well. So let's address the first one here right off the bat. So we have last year's Galaxy Book Pro 360 and this year's Galaxy Book 2 Pro 360. They're both in amber status, which means they're both charging right now, and we're still cranking out 4850 milliamps on the Tab S8 Ultra sitting here charging. So three devices going strong. Let's address a second concern from another user. That's about the iPad and iPhone. So we got ourselves an iPad and an iPhone. Let's go ahead and plug these in real quick. All right. Charging. My fiance loves Michael Jackson. I'm a Metallica guy. She's a Michael Jackson gal. They both start with M, right? Let's go ahead and get the iPad plugged in. Okay. Charging. I've got charging indicator on the iPad. Go back to the iPhone. Let's take a look. Charging indicator is on, guys. Don't know if that's showing up on the camera because I got the focus locked. We have five devices charging right now, and we are still charging the Tab S8 Ultra at roughly the same speed that the Samsung brick was charging at on its own. Five devices going at once. Let's fill the device itself. Let's fill the charger. Not bad. I mean, it's warm. You can feel it, guys. It's definitely warm, but it is not hot by any means. This is no more warm than what the Samsung brick gets at all. So, all right, guys, so let's go ahead and talk about the pros and cons. So the pros to me, number one is the price, $35. You're gonna get it for $32 after the coupon code. Pick up a couple of these, one for your bedroom, one for your office or something. Charge everything at once. You're not gonna have to worry about it. The other thing I really like too is the form factor. I like that it comes with this little cradle that you can sit it up like this so it's secure. You know, you don't have your charger sliding all over the place like you do when you have the cheap ones that don't weigh anything. Another pro that I really like is the fact that it has a power cord that plugs in instead of this like hooking directly into your wall like most bricks do. You know, this puts a lot less strain on your wall outlet itself, and it gives you the option of, you know, putting this out in the middle of your table or somewhere on your desk without having to run some type of janky extension cord to one of your bricks, you know, and having it sticking up. I never liked doing that, but you know, we all do it. Put it behind furniture and hide it so people don't see it. Now you don't have to worry about hiding stuff and just leave it out here. The other thing I like too is that it seems to just consistently work. I mean, for $35, I mean, I don't even expect three of these ports to work at the same time, let alone all five. We got five devices going right now, guys. Two laptops. We got an iPad, we've got an iPhone, and we've got the Tab S8 Ultra. And we can see here with the amperage meter, it's still pulling a great draw, no issues. Are there any cons? So, I mean, the only real con that I'll ding it for is, you know, it doesn't quite have that, that solid build quality that like this Samsung brick has. And this is a nice brick. I mean, this isn't your standard like USB charger. This thing is like a rock, man. It's like holding a little boulder in your hands. So I mean, this does feel the part, you know, it feels totally premium. Whereas this one, you know, it's quite a bit lighter. It weighs maybe half as much, maybe two thirds as much as a Samsung. Not light, but then again, you know, you can tell it's not quite the full real deal. It's like the Samsung. All right, guys, so do I recommend it? Yeah, definitely, definitely. I think it's holding up real well. I'm gonna use it for a lot of my devices around the house. I think I'll make this like the family one, and I'll stick with my two Samsung bricks just for my Samsung devices inside the office. But yeah, this is gonna be great for the family. Hope that you guys get some good use out of it too. And don't forget the links in the description to save 10% off on this. There won't be too many videos like this on the channel, guys, but I do like to entertain them once in a while, especially when the company I'm working with is willing to work with me. You know, like I made it very clear that if I didn't like it, I'm not reviewing it. They were A-okay with that. That tells me that they're confident in their own product. So that's good. I can stand behind that. All right, guys. Hope you enjoyed this one. As always, thanks for watching.